wants me to write this. She want me to write it. Now suppose I'm telling you what should be done. Suppose the elements are this. Suppose these are the elements. This is the input of the list. The output shall be. You have to shift the elements to the left side, right?
Sir, I have solved this question by using append and pop function. So it is right.
Using pop and append.
Yes.
For this, you have to use pop. Can be used. No issues in that. There's no use of using pop and append, Himanshu. There's no need to use that. You can do directly.
But sir, it's working.
It will be working. I have it will be working. But instead of using inbuilt functions, we can do it manually also. How? Taking the list first of all from the user. So you have taken the list, calculated the length. Now, what I have done is I have taken the first element in a variable first. I am going to shift the elements to the left side. So what I have done is I have stored this element, which is at the 0th index, in a variable that is first. Applying the loop for I in range from 0 to your L minus 1. Let's see what we have to do. So L1 of I is equals to L1 of I plus 1. Let me check whether this program will be working correct or not. Let's see. Then L1 of L minus 1 is equals to first. Print L1. So let's see whether this will be working correct or not. So we have the first element, that is 2. Let me do the manual execution. The first is 2. The value of I is 0. So L1 of I plus 1, that is the element which is on the first index, that is 4, will be now placed at the 0th position. Yes or no?
But sir, we have to shift the element to n number of times.
Was it n number of times? Okay, left side n number.
Yes,
of times. Okay, let me do one thing. Let me write the program for the for just one time, and if the program is correct, then we just have to apply an outer loop, and it will be working for the n number of times.
Okay. Okay, sir.
We have copied this 4 here, incremented the loop. The value of I is now 1. The element which is at the second index will come at the first index. That is 7. Moving I to the second index. Now this will be 1. This will be 9 for the value of I equals to 3. So it will be working till here only. Okay, this is correct. And then the first, that was 2, is here. Okay, the program is working correct. We just have to write it for the n number of times. Enter the number of times you want to type. So I in range n using. We have taken first to VL1 of 0. Loop is here. Suppose it is J now. J equals to J plus 1. So we'll be doing this work again and again and again and again. Okay. This is correct. This is the program for the third question. Clear, students? Himanshu, is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts to anyone?
No, sir.
Chalo. Moving to the next one. Write a program to search for an element. I think again there is no need of writing this program. We already have done this program in the class only. Right?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. Now, fifth question, first part. So we have a list. This is 678, 89. This, okay, we have a list like this. It says what is the LN of it says what is the index of 89. So n equals to 1 plus, because the index of 89 is 1, that says plus ln dot index 42, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is 5. So value of n becomes 6, right? It prints ln dot count 89. So 89 is being repeated 2 times, so the value will be printed as 2. This is the final output that I'm printing here. Okay. And we are doing the manual execution here. It says then ln dot append ln dot count of 100. 100 is 0, 0 plus 34 is 34. 34 will get appended at the last of the list. Okay. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Length is 8. Length will be 8 after appending an element in the list. So is this the output? 2. And in the next line it is 8. Is it correct?
So,
students, is it correct?
By 8 output came out.
Yes, sir.
Now, how many elements are there right now? 7?
Yes, sir.
This statement that ln.append, it says that you have to append an element. How many elements do we have to append? ln.count of 100, it is 0. We don't have any element with 100. It will be 0. 0 plus 34 is 34. So append element 34 in the list. Earlier it was 7, but now one more element has got appended, that is 34. So and after that we are printing the length of 11, so it will be printed as 8. Okay. Moving to the next one. Now, okay, so LN is 56. So let me take this as an input for the manual execution. Okay, so we have this list right now. Second statement says that we have to extend it. Extend with elements 85 and 63. Appended. Now it says that add. It says that insert 99 at the third position. So 0, 1, 2, 3. 99 will get appended here. ln.pop. Now, pop is empty. Which element will get deleted from the list? First or last? If there is nothing, if there is no
last
will get deleted. So 63 from the list is deleted now. Print ln. So this ln will get printed. Let me write down output will be, first of all, this will be the output. Then it says ln.insert 0, 0, 101. So 101 is here now. Insert 111 at the second position, 0, 1, 2. 111 is here. Pop 2, 0, 1, 2. 111 again deleted. Remove ABC. ABC removed. Print 11. Now this list will get printed. This is the final output. These two lists will be the final output. Clear? Are there any doubts?
No, sir.
Clear? Everyone? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So shall we move to the next topic, that is tuples now? Starting with a new chapter today, that is tuples. So tuples basically are the sequence, but they are immutable. it will look like list, but list and tuples have a major difference that tuples are of immutable types and lists are of mutable types. So tuples are nothing but a immutable sequence. They are obviously they are ordered. Okay. So let's see how to create a tuple. So creating an empty tuple. So empty tuple can be created using these parentheses or using the tuple function. So empty tuple can be created using empty parentheses and or using the tuple function. Creating a tuple with elements. So as you have seen that list can be created of integer type, of float type.
Is it indexed?
It is indexed. It is indexed. It is sequence, immutable type, ordered and indexed. So creating a tuple with elements. As you had seen that in the list manipulations, the list can be created of, the list could be of your integer types, of float types, of character types, of string types, or of mixed types. Similarly, a tuple can also be created of integer, float, character, string, or mixed type. But there's a thing, there's a difference between creation of a list and a tuple of a single element. But what if I want to create a list with a single element? I'll be simply writing like this. So this is a list of single element. This is single element list. Now, what if I want to create a single element tuple? What would I do? By now, some of you will be saying, sir, aise kar do. It will create a single element tuple. How many of you agree with this? How many of you agree with this, that this will create a single element tuple? Tell me. By you agree with this? Because yes. See, listen, this L1 equals to 2. This is a single element list. It is correct. So now what if I want to create a single element tuple? So most of you will be saying, sir, aise bana do, aise ban jayega. But no, this is a wrong method to create a single element tuple. If you're going to create a single element tuple, then you have to mention comma after the element. If there's a single element in the tuple, suppose it is 2. So to make it a tuple, you have to mention a comma after that. If you are not mentioning a comma, and if you print the type of T, it will print, suppose we have T1 and we have T2. Okay. So we have two things. If you are printing the type of T1 and if you are printing the type of T2, we'll print class tuple. But this will print class int. This is the difference between these two statements. If you want to create a single element tuple, then after the element, you have to mention the comma. If you're not mentioning the comma, then it will assume that it is a simple integer type or float type, whatever value you have taken, it will assume that that kind of literal, that T2 or whatever the variable is. So if you want to make a single element tuple, mention comma after that, after the element. Is it clear or you have some doubts in this?
So for two elements, I'll have to print 2, comma, 2, again, comma.
No, it is only for single element. Now see, suppose I'm creating a tuple of 2 elements. So suppose it is 2, comma, 6. It is a 2 element tuple. This is correct. That rule is only for single element tuple. If you are creating a tuple with multiple elements, then there is no need of mentioning comma after the last element. But if you are creating a single element tuple, then yes, for sure, you have to mention the comma. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. क्लियर? यस
एंड नॉट राइट टू कॉमा विल इट बी कंसीडर्ड अ टपल?
कनक प्लीज बी लाउडर.
Sir, if I'm writing tuple before the parenthesis and entering two only without the comma, will it be considered a tuple?
You means that you are writing it
tuple
like
parenthesis two. Yeah, that's it.
So tuple function will create an empty single element tuple. So when you are going to print this, it will print like this. वो तो यू हैव यूज द फंक्शन ना, अब तो यहाँ फंक्शन टपल यूज कर लिया तो वो तो ऑटोमेटिकली उसको टू कॉमा कर देगा. व्हाट इफ आई एम एंटरिंग द टपल मैन्युअली, देन व्हाट? इन दैट केस यू हैव टू मेंशन कॉमा आफ्टर द सिंगल, इट इज अ सिंगल एलिमेंट टपल. इफ यू आर यूजिंग द टपल फंक्शन देयर इज नो नीड. क्लियर? ओके, नेक्स्ट. अच्छा, टपल कैन बी ऑफ योर integer type, tuple can be of your float type, tuple can be of character type, tuple can be of string type. Tuple can be of mixed. ठीक है, so tuples can be created of integer type, float type, character type, string type, or of mixed types. ठीक है. Yes or no? बोलो.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
चलो. Now, I've told you one thing, that tuples are immutable. What is immutability? If you are having a tuple like this, and I mention that t of one. अच्छा, what is the element on t of one?
Six.
I've written that t of one should become 9. What it will do?
False.
False? No. It will give an error. Okay, tuples being an immutable type, you cannot change the values. Okay. So tuple is a immutable type. If you are saying that I want to change a value in the tuple, no, it is not allowed at all. Clear? To take tuple from the user, we are creating a tuple on shell. So basically we want to take the tuple from the user, so we'll be simply writing as eval, same thing, same statement that we have written in the for the list. So enter a tuple. Just the difference will be that while entering the tuple, I'll be mentioning these parentheses. Instead of writing square brackets, I'll be mentioning parentheses, so automatically it will become a tuple. Right? Me, I'm not getting any kind of responses. Kana, after a very long time, I'm seeing you in the class. All good?
Yes, sir.
Rishabh, are you getting it? See, out of 43 students, only 28 students are here in the class. So we have taken a tuple from the user. Next concept traversing a tuple. See, most of the concepts are same as in list, but there are some functions which are not applicable in tuples which were there in the list. Append, extend, pop, remove, all these functions will not work in tuple because tuples are of immutable types. So traversing of a tuple is quite similar that we have done in the case of list. So if you're having a tuple like having 4 or 5 elements, whatever they are, and I just apply a loop for int printing the element I. So this is a traversing. This is a way to traverse the tuple. Or second way is the length function. So for I in range L, print T of I. So there are two methods to traverse a tuple, similar as we have seen in the list manipulations. These two methods. One is directly pointing to the elements of the list, and second is the pointing to the indexes of the tuple. And second is the pointing to the indexes of the tuple. Any doubts in these two things? The traversing of a tuple. Any doubts?
No, sir.
All right. Next. Do you want me to teach you indexing and slicing again? It is similar as was it was in list. Tell me. So let us do one thing. Let us ask some questions from indexing and slicing. Okay. So, actually, these are quite interesting question. Let us come to AC path. इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन है, प्लीज टेल मी कि क्या होगा. दिस इज 2, 3, 9. इफ आई से यस, टेल मी output for this particular code fragment. Will it give an error or will they output something different? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Tell me the output for this code fragment. Hurry up. Akansha, what do you think the output? Yes? Akansha, what should be the output of this? Akansha is not there.
So I don't know.
Okay. Aryan Sinha.
So 1.
Mm-hmm. Bhavya Bhardwaj.
7.
Kuch bhi aise. See what I have done here. What this statement says. It says that the element which is at second index, so 0, 1, the second index pe list hai. Theek hai. Do we have list at this particular second index? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Us second index pe jo bhi aapki ye sequence hai, list hai, us list ke first index pe kya hai?
7.
7 ko kya kar do?
8
kar do. But now the thing is ये तो टपल है, टपल इम्यूटेबल टाइप होती है. सो विल इट चेंज द एलिमेंट और नॉट?
नो सर.
बट द एलिमेंट इज अ लिस्ट, सो आई थिंक इट विल चेंज.
17 इज अ लिस्ट.
17, वेरी गुड मानव. भाई टपल इज नॉट म्यूटेबल बट अ लिस्ट इज म्यूटेबल एंड वी हैव पॉइंटेड टू व्हाट? वी हैव पॉइंटेड टू अ लिस्ट. गिव मी अ सेकंड स्टूडेंट्स. भाई आई वांट टू टेक द अटेंडेंस जस्ट गिव मी अ सेकंड स्टूडेंट्स Just give me a second. So it is 2nd of December. Akansha?
Present, sir.
Arav Grewal?
Sir, Arav Grewal present.
Arav Sharma? Ish? Priya?
Present, sir.
Akshita? Omar?
Present, sir.
Anshika, Romita,
present sir.
Aryan Sinha,
present sir.
Aryan Sharma, sorry, Ayush Sharma, Ardwaj,
present sir.
Ajay Mishra,
present sir.
Daman. Lunch.
Present, sir.
Gautam Kakkar. Gautam Kakkar. Gautam Kumar.
Present, sir.
Anshu.
Present, sir.
Jayant. Kanak?
Present, sir.
Kana?
Present, sir.
Kunjal? She is left. Kansal?
Present, sir.
Anoy? Anav?
Present, sir.
Pragya.
Present, sir.
Rishabh. Rishabh.
Himanshu, sir. Good morning.
Present, sir. Good morning, ma'am.
Sir, ek bar attendance bhej dijiye. Yahan urgent hai.
Ma'am, I'm just taking the attendance.
Haan, sir. Ek bar leke bhej denge aap. Theek hai?
Haan. It will hardly take 2 minutes, ma'am.
Theek hai. Theek hai. Thank you, sir.
Rishabh, present.
Yes, sir, present.
Rohan? Sahil Bisht? Sahil Bisht? Al Sharma? Ankit? Priyam? Shashwat? What happened? Where are the students? Sahil Sharma, you are there in the class? Shashwat, Sahil, Sayyam?
Yes, sir.
Why are you not speaking? Shivansh? Shriya Mishra?
Present, sir.
Dhan Sharma? Siddharth?
Present, sir.
Siddharth Jain. Siddharth Semwal.
Present, sir.
Shishti Singh. Okay. Sanket is absent, na? Sahil Bisht is also absent. Rohan is absent.
Sir Vani present.
Vani and Vanshika I've seen.
Sir Sahil Sharma present.
Sahil Sharma. Sahil Sharma to present. Linoy is absent. Kunjali is absent. Jayanti is absent. Gautam Kakkar Galaxy is absent. Devansh Daman. Ayush Sharma. Anshika Akshita Aman. Agnish. They are absent.
सर अमन प्रेजेंट मैंने बोला भी था तब
अच्छा अमन बोला था ओके डियर यस सर
यस
Just give me a second, Hana. I'm just sending the attendance. Okay, moving further. So was this concept clear to you? Chalo, let me tell you again. What it says that tuple is an immutable type, but we are talking about a list here. We have pointed that T of 2 is a list. So whatever element you want to change in this particular list, in this sequence, yes, it is, it can be done. It is allowed because it's a list, not a tuple. What if I would have written, this will create an error. This would have given me an error. Okay, this is not allowed. You cannot change any element in the tuple. But in case of list, yes, you can do that. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. So indexing and slicing. So let's do one thing. Indexing and slicing will be starting in the tomorrow's class only. Let us keep it till here only. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Goodbye. Take care, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.